Two off days they have waited. And now this time they wait more. At Old Chicago Stadium, it was 22 steps up from the dressing room and then onto the ice. Here it's about the same number of steps, but level ones. The first one brings the horn from the good ship Blackhawk. Check, what will you be watching for when this game starts?
Length of shifts per player. More times than not, it's somewhere in that 40-second range, and even strength, Doc, 5-on-5. A lot made of the triple overtime game, but to me, watching how long these guys play on a particular even strength shift.
To the ice, Pierre McGuire and the Blackhawks' Patrick Sharp.
Thanks very much, Doc. What'd you like tactically about your game one that you can carry over to game two?
I thought as the game went on, I know we played a lot of periods, we got more and more pucks to the net. Guys driving and looking for those second and third rebounds. You know, these guys make it tough to play out here, so that's our formula.
Patrick, they want to get pucks deep and grind on your defense. How do you counteract that?
Well, we got to work in five-man units. All year we've done a good job of coming back as forwards and bailing out our D. I like our 6G, I put them up against any other top six in the league. So I'm going to work as a unit.
How do you survive all the attrition that's happened so far early on in this series?
Yeah, it feels like we've been playing for weeks against these guys, you know, and we expect a tough series. We knew that coming into it. It's going to be a fun game tonight.
Get out there and have some fun, Patrick.
All right, thanks, Jim.
Doc?
I remember this very time of the evening a couple of years ago. I was here as a spectator and hurrying to get from the concourse to my seat so I could hear the anthem and watch it. Hurrying just ahead of me for the same reason was another spectator, Hall of Famer Ed Belfour, who played goal for 18 years. His next words were pretty impressive. A guy who played over 1,100 NHL games and more in Chicago than anywhere said, "I'm not missing this. We don't want you to miss this either." So a little cheering room as we start, and then the voice of public address announcer, Gene Honda.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Kindly remove all hats to honor U.S. Army Sergeant Dale Dick, Army National Guard Brigadier General Richard Hayes, U.S. Navy Petty Officer Third Class Tony Durkin, and joint organist Frank Pellico and soloist Jim Cornelison for the singing of our national anthem.
In both cities, the vocalists wear championship rings. Somebody's going to get another once we're done. 132 shots were taken at Tuukka Rask on Wednesday. 63 were on goal. He got 59, the last an impossible double deflection. 85 shots were taken at Corey Crawford Wednesday. 54 on goal. He stopped 51. These two goalies are number one and two in wins and goals against and save percentage. Speaking of best, the two best faceoff men in the entire league this past season, Jonathan Toews, winner of the Selke Trophy for best defensive forward, will take the first one against Patrice Bergeron, winner of the King Clancy Award for leadership and humanitarian contribution. No lineup changes for either team. Dan O'Halloran, Wes McCauley are the referees. Jay Scherz, Pierre Rassico, the linesman. Bergeron prevails on the first. Ferentz sent one along that was just deflected away from the reach of Jágr and then pushed back in off of Crawford and rattled around where Bergeron stops it.
Boy, a difficult stop there for Corey Crawford. I don't think he saw that puck off the shot from Johnny Boychuk on the red line. That puck dipped and dived and he had to fight that thing off.
It is Seabrook turning with this one. That one connected back out to Marian Hossa, moves back in with Brandon Saad. Hossa turns and bounces one around in front that rattled across and struck Saad where it can be played back along by Hossa and then Toews walled by Chara. Rolled off of that, Chara back after him again. A little shove there as it comes along to Saad. Looks to Seabrook for the drive and that one blocked wide by Rask. Jágr dueling there and slung it back in and will come to the bench for a change in line. A difficult first stop for Crawford. A routine but acrobatic second stop by Rask. Kane with a shot that's blocked down. Lost on out to center by Daugavans. Kaspers Daugavans was pretty impressive but also was a little upset at himself. In the pregame, you saw his opportunity to end the game for Boston. And Mike Milbury's comment that there should have been a penalty on the play. Bounced on around now and taken for a shot by Sharp that is covered by Rask.
Well, a quick little exit from Brent Seabrook up to Marian Hossa. Speed through the middle of the ice. Simple little play. Just get the puck to the front of the net. That just went under the stick blade of Jonathan Toews as he went hard to the net through the middle of the ice.
Well, if you're a Blackhawks fan, you love the way all three forwards went to the net. The two guys without the puck and the puck carrier, that makes it hard. And that defense pair of Seidenberg and Chara, who lost so many minutes.
Centering pass is flagged by Bergeron and wafted on out on his backhand to center. Most road wins in the playoffs, Boston, 5. Most home wins, Chicago, 10. Most road goals, 27 by Boston. Most home goals, 37 by Chicago. Rifled back in by Bergeron, and around it curls for Jágr. Began the Stanley Cup final as a teenager, and now in his 40s, the only guy in history to have done that. The fans had their arms up. None from the two referees. Marchand able to swing it back onto Jágr. Around behind is Bergeron, expecting the pass that does come to him. And then back for Jágr again. Jágr centered one, and it was blocked, and then waving at it was Marchand, played on by Seabrook, off the stick of Chara, and Chara will retreat to play. 2.5 gone here in the first. Slowed for Hjalmarsson, and lofted on out. Would you define this as a careful start thus far?
I would say for the most part, just not a lot of going on for either side. A lot of play through this area of the ice, the neutral zone.
The big line for Boston is out there now, the one that both Coach Claude Julien of the Bruins and Joel Quenneville of the Blackhawks paid tribute to after the first game. And that is Krejci with Lucic and Horton. Horton comes to the bench now on a change. Back up to Lucic it comes. He got the first two goals. Led back across for a little plop right back in again. That done by Ferentz. A shoulder that came from Sean Thornton. Letty sent it ahead. Chopped on now, and Sharp will go retreating to play. Shoved into the boards by Boychuk, and it's played back on and taken up the boards by Chris Kelly and dropped on back for Ferentz. And then Kelly yet again. Ferentz played more than any Bruin in the game on Wednesday. And that was quite a tribute to him, because normally Zdeno Chara does. Let's take a look at the Coors Light cold hard facts. The game stopped on a hand pass gives us a chance to hand this to you. Winning two straight games in multiple overtimes, the Blackhawks of 13, way back the Oilers, way, way back the Canadians, and in arcane times, sorry, the Chicago Blackhawks of 31. Kruger about to duel here with Peverly, and finally Kruger is tossed. One again by the Bruins, and this time it's McQuaid on a cross now for Krug. Led back ahead now. Sagan a shot. Pad stop and a cover by Crawford.
Some confidence for Krug from his coach. Liam, Mike, and Keith are talking about it. Sagan takes that Karen pass from Krug, but Eddie, everybody focus in on that turnover from game one. Krug not showing any lack of confidence going cross ice there.
Yeah, set face off play by the Bruins in the middle of the ice, and the only way you can do that is if you win the faceoff. Beverly was able to do it.
This one up for grabs until it's played on by Letty. Careened across to Bolick. And the big man is able to trickle it back in. Going back in with McQuaid. Took the bump. Puck skittered on now for Krug. Lobbed one along. Missed for Dogovins, though. And a strange carom off a glass support. Turnaround shot by Prolik is blocked. Taken back on by Kruger. Worked on to Bolick. Led it to the back where it's handed across to Letty. His shot was stifled. Chipped that by Kruger, and it ricocheted right back. Bolick is stepped into as that pass was flagged by Dogovin.
That was Krug that took a run at Bolick.
Beverly trying to step by, no luck there. And back in for Rask, and both teams will make a change in line.
Good first shift there for Torrey Krug.
That's the curse of a misplay, isn't it? Especially with 2 days off. People ask you for 2 days instead of one. Chalmerson jammed it on, taken there by Andrew Shaw. Armory guy for the Blackhawks filters it in and goes in after it. Oh, and then down goes Ferentz, and play continues. Along it comes to Marchand. Tied up there, and it's poked back along near him by Bergeron and then controlled to Jágr. Jágr with a look, tried to send one through, but Shaw blocked that. Chopped nearly out of play, persistently by Bergeron, and turned over to the Blackhawks, but at center. So 5 minutes have been played now. Carried on by Hossa. Scooped up by Rask.
You're talking about Torrey Krug. No lack of confidence in game two, but this could have caused a lack of confidence. Turns it over to Andrew Shaw. Shaw makes a real deft play to Bolick, and Bolick puts it to the back of the net. You can see the young man who was a CCHA Player of the Year in Michigan State. He's ready to play here tonight. And I love the way Claude Julien handled it on the two off days, Doc and Eddie. We had a chance to visit with him, and all he kept saying was, he's a good player, we need him, and we back him.
This one is won by the Blackhawks to Johnny Oduya with a shot that is turned aside through a screen by Rask. Fed around behind for Chara. And banked off the stick of Peverly, brushed on by Krejci. Hustling back is Oduya. Canceled out by Krejci. Jalmerson is walled by Lucic. Puck comes back to Horton. Horton got it in close quarters to Krejci, led to the back to Chara, across to Seidenberg, and he dubbed his shot, and his stick failed him. He's going to remain out as the lone defenseman with a stick, Chara, plays it, and it's soccered right ahead by Seidenberg, who now crawls over the board.
Chara did not know that Seidenberg had broken a stick.
Here's Tate jamming one in front. Oh, and a good stick lift done there by Chara. Krejci led it back ahead, carried back on by Lucic, dropped off to Krejci, poked away by Hossa, hurrying off his Chara so they don't get banged for too many men. Led back up the wing, Boland across to Letty, save! Made by that lightning-like glove held by Rask. 6:09 play. 7 shots. 5 for the Blackhawks. As the fans stand, we have no score. Welcome back to the Stanley Cup Final presented by Geico.
Well, what an opportunity coming, that last chance for the Blackhawks. 2 defensemen jumping into the play. Rolls the ball on Letty, and a good stop by Tuukka Rask.
dug out at the boards and played into traffic. Hanzus lost it. Regathered and poked on out to center, striding as Bergeron. Denied by Hanzus, but he recoiled and bashed it back in, and it slowed down behind by Crawford. Oh, and then a little trip there on Marchand, as they remember game one, where there was something similar the other way. Oh, and a big collision at the line involving a number 55 that is not Cronwall, it is Boychuk. Must be with the number played along now by Ferentz. He's run into, turned around for Shaw. Set aside by Rask, can't grab it though. Then down to the ice. There'll be a penalty drawn by Bickle. And the Bruins touch, and they are shorthanded.
It all started with Johnny Boychuk going for the big hit on Andrew Shaw. 65 red. Shaw doesn't quit on the play, and neither does Bickle. And eventually the stick of Andrew Ferentz will go right into the feet of Brian Bickle. Right there, down he goes. Wes McCauley there to make the call. Power play for Chicago. Have they fixed it? 1-for-21 in the last seven games for Chicago on a power play.
The Bruins penalty kill, 18 straight. Power play is sponsored by Ford. Jonathan Taves on the draw with Rich Peverly. That is cleared off the short glass and down by Boychuk. Andrew Ferentz gets a tripping minor that has brought this about. Only Ferentz's second minor penalty of the playoffs. None of the Bruins have more than 16. And this is the fourth round, cleared by Kelly. None of the Blackhawks have more than Andrew Shaw's 26, and he got a batch of those all at once. It has been largely peaceful so far. Keith drops it off. Taves plays it ahead off of Hossa and back in deep. Chara to play that. Taves to get that. More resistance, and it comes on back to Seabrook. He's got Keith across, watching his Krejci, and then Paye as it's sent on to Hossa. Some sparring at the front. Hossa fed one on over to Keith. He's chased off by Paye. And then Shaw slipped one wide. Forced on around by Seidenberg. Kept alive by Seabrook. Fired on around for Hossa. Rushed a bit by Krejci. Puck to the back now to Keith. Then across to Hossa. Shooting one, and it was blocked wide by Seidenberg, who is just splendid at that. Taken to the outside by Shaw. Watched there by Chara. Around behind to Seidenberg, ladled it on his backhand and unable to play as Krejci. Set up now to the back for Hossa. Hossa fires! Blocked off in front, scramble there! Off the glove of Shaw. It's knifed on back to center and an extra whack on Shaw that comes from Chara. And the two of them tangle and are warned by the referee. Wes McCauley was yelling at both of them. One shot on goal by the Blackhawks in this power play that's got 8 seconds to go in. Ahead now, it's Letty. Letty, tuck one in front. Oh, and it wouldn't go through. Rask on the try from Sharp.
Well, a real good rush by Nick Letty to get the puck to Patrick Sharp from our Crown Royal RoboCam. Speed to the outside, throw it to the front of the net. The first shot was denied by Adam McQuaid. A real good defensive play, and then Rask is able to stop the second chance right there out of midair. What a play by Sharp and Rask.
Two shots on goal on this power play that has a single second to go in it. Settled down by Oduya. Out of the box is Ferentz. Jalmerson gives it back to him. And Kane backhanded it off the short glass and in. Played along by Boychuk, waiting as Marchand, gliding along with it is Bergeron. Sped back onto Marchand, tries to get by Oduya. Jágr a shot, swept out of the air by Crawford.
Eddie, they're trying to go high glove on Corey Crawford, and he's shutting it down on him. Jágr, Patrice Bergeron, and Brad Marchand all touch the puck in this sequence. Bergeron spins, gives it to Marchand. Marchand will give it to Jágr right there. And then Corey Crawford with the glove again. Eddie, his glove has been really working in this series so far.
Well, two of three goals in game one were over the glove hand side of Corey Crawford. But he's made some outstanding stops. Brad Marchand had a great one in game one. Crawford denied in there. Jágr with a real good opportunity. Too much time and space there if you're the Blackhawks set of defensemen there with Marchand and Jágr with that high-quality chance from about 25 feet out.
Pretty apparent Boston trying to go there a lot.
Barron slams one that's wide off the boards perfectly to Krejci. Krejci turned and is walled effectively by Bolin. Turn to Kruger, led back across. Johnny Oduya nudges it on. Pickle sidled up to and taken out of the play by McQuaid. So it is Lucic. Connects on across. Horton tried to swing one on. It is blocked down, and then Shaw with a effort that was impeded by Horton, and it was blocked off by McQuaid. And then McQuaid chased off by Bickle's hitting. McQuaid, a large guy, so also is Bickle. Though the average in the league is 6'1", 205, those guys are well beyond that. Carried back on by McQuaid, banked further, and that ricocheted in off Horton. Crawford to Oduya. Jalmerson, nudged there by Krejci, pivoting is Horton, led it to the back. Krug handed it across. It's Boychuk giving it on back. Krug shuffled it over. Horton twisted it back in and Krejci to get it. Jalmerson lifted it away from him, jammed on back, but through Lucic, played carefully on back to center by Johnny Oduya. And that one is blocked up high by Oduya and can be feathered on back to him by Kruger. Past the halfway point of the first, shots are 8-3 in favor of the Blackhawks, no score. The probing continues. Rask decides enough. So just one penalty. An uneventful kill, an uneventful power play, and no score.
This game so far?
Pretty intense. Crowd's into it. You know, we had a couple of good looks on the power play. I like the way we started the game.
What did you like? Which looks did you like on the power play?
We had dunks for a one time. It looks like he had an empty net. Nick Leddy coming in, and then slot wide open. Two great opportunities.
Excellent, Joel.
You betcha.
13 years ago today, Joel Quenneville was named winner of the Jack Adams Award for Coach of the Year of the St. Louis Blues. And he was drafted 21st overall by Toronto 35 years ago today. He would like to be up 2-0 later on tonight, or if necessary, in the morning. Well, it's shoved on now for the turning Hanzus. Gallops ahead and punches one on that slowed down and shuffled right on goal and nicely geared away by Tukarask. That try came from Sharp. Chipped on back across, and it will be read by Roosevelt.
Eddie, what a skating matchup between Sagan and Leddy when they're on the ice together. Fun to watch.
Sharp led one ahead, trying to dance free as Kane, and a backhander is gloved and then dropped and then punched on back for a shot. Another save, Rask. Scramble there. Help comes. It came into the crease and was swatted away. Another try. They score!
Play through the middle of the ice by Patrick Kane starts it off. There's a stop. There's a second stop. Roosevelt with an opportunity. There's another. Five saves by Tukarask. Dogovich keeps that puck out of the net. And then Tukarask not able to get back to his feet. And Sharp from near the sideboards gives the Blackhawks a 1-0 lead.
And that's got to be a sense of relief for Patrick Sharp and the Chicago Blackhawks. 8 shots in game one. And he gets one right there to go to the back of the net. Just turn and fire it through a maze of players.
Hans was right in the crease there, not allowing Tuukka Rask to get back to his feet. And I think that's the conversation being had. You see the reaction off the face, on the face of Claude Julien. But boy, what a mad scramble. 4 or 5 stops by Tuukka Rask before Sharp was able to shoot one outside the faceoff dots.
No one has more goals than Patrick Sharp nor David Krejci in these playoffs. 9 apiece. Seabrook chopped it along. Shaw to get it there and a little tap and they escape. Bolin skyhooks one on, hoping for Bickle. Got what he wanted. Bickle was crashed into by McQuaid and it scaled off the short glass back up the center. The lonesome end was Yager. It's pulled and fired back in again by Bolin. Krug allows it to go. Marchand tried to sweep it along. Bickle able to keep play going here. And all of this is onside. Led toward the front and swung away by McQuaid. But the Bruins are defending more than they want. Punch back in, and it's Bickle. In the shadow of the referee, still trying to work free, and Krug on him. Coming along is Marchand. Again back to Krug. Another line change for Chicago as Krug tried to filter it through, no luck, and they come right back in. It's Hossa, and that one patted away by Raz.
Great play by Nathan Horton.
He caught up and stymied the shot. A wraparound, and a jam play is held off by Raz on the try by Jonathan Toews. It is all Chicago at 15 shots to 3.
On turnover in the middle of the ice, Torrey Krug. The Blackhawks are fresh off the ice. Here comes Marian Hossa. That's a great back check there from Nathan Horton, denying Marian Hossa the initial opportunity. And then Toews wraps his puck from below the goal line. And it's just another mad scramble in the crease of Tuukka Rask.
Talked about that hustle, Eddie. Here it is right now. Horton off the bench and gets a stick into the lane. So he makes Hossa's shot a little easier for Tuukka Rask to digest. Then the wraparound attempt, and you got bodies getting the net. Chicago's done a nice job to start this game getting bodies to the net. They really have.
Left part of your screen, this is where Toews is wrapping the puck around. The referee was in a real good spot. Wes McCauley had great position right behind the net. And as soon as he lost sight of it, he blew through his arms up and blew the whistle. And on those looks there, could lost sight of the puck, did not see that puck at all after it came off the stick of Jonathan Toews.
It is a major event in a young referee's life to do his first Stanley Cup final game, and tonight is the night for Wes McCauley. This is not long distance. The guys he's talking to are now in the building.
Talked about the neutral zone, the middle of the ice, the area between the two blue lines. You turn the puck over against either one of these teams, they're quick striking teams. They go back the other way right away. You can't hope plays through the middle of the ice. The turnover, the quick change, and we saw the effort from Nathan Horton putting the pressure on Marian Hossa. Never got a shot on goal, but then the support, the fresh people on the ice, created that chance around the crease. That's the right part of your screen. Excuse me, the left part of your screen. There's Wes McCauley right there. Throws his arms up. Perfect positioning. Getting worked over there by the three Blackhawk players below the goal line.
The evidence must reverse his call on the ice. Or otherwise, it is no goal and play will continue.
Any way you slice it, this has been a great start for Chicago. 15-3 are the shots. They lead 1-0, and they're putting a lot of pressure on Tuukka Rask and the Bruins defense.
Maybe the Bruins catch a break by the delay, because they sure had momentum.
Wes McCauley still talking. Puck ends up in the net, but way after the whistle.
After reviewing the play, the call on the ice stands, no goal.
Pierre mentioned 15-3 the shots. Scoring chances 10-1. Chicago. Offensive zone faceoff for Joel Quenneville's team.
And the one chance for Fox and Lejarmer Yager, high glove on Corey Crawford. He nailed that one. He just snagged it right out of the air.
So the young man from Finland is keeping his team in here. aided by Gogovins in one netmouth scramble before Sharp actually did score.
And what a sequence. In four saves in a matter of maybe 5 seconds.
Off the tie-up, it squirts back to Seidenberg, rifled it off the boards, and ahead now for Krejci. Feeds on to Lucic, gives on a cross. It is Kelly trying to reach through there and poke it along. Lucic jamming there with Johnny Oduya. It's pulled free by Taves, but chopped loose back over near Krejci, and then tumbling down to the ice. Play continues there. It was Saad, and this one shanked on a cross by Hossa in a tough play for him. Scaled back along, and Hossa gloved it down, got it to Saad. Blocked out in front. Turned around further. As Seidenberg got in the way, it's sent wide by Taves. Taves trying to play it further. Chopped on by Chara. Stepping to it is Horton. Horton jammed one back out to center. Johnny Oduya took over there. Swedish-born tandem is out now for the Blackhawks defense. Hjalmarsson and Oduya, but just as I say that, they come to the bench for a change. It is Frolik's line that is out now for Chicago to go against Krejci. Duncan Keith, menaced by Krejci, coming by as Lucic, tried to play a three, but could not, and the Blackhawks are able to get it as far as center.
Offside! Offside!
The late offside is now wiped as the Blackhawks send it down, and Krug retrieves. Away from Kruger. Krug saw that one go on to Bolig. Krug shoving him. Bolig just trying to bully his way through. Helped along by Frolik, and it went through Seabrook and must be played back out. The good defensive play was made there by Rich Pepper. So it's Keith on a cross and off the boards for Kruger. Under 6 minutes to go, first period. Blackhawks by one. Kruger in front. Oh, and that shot was flexed away by Rask from the stick of Frolik. Played on now, and Peverly has a man around in front, but that pass wouldn't reach. And so it's Frolik starting back the other way and pivoting in traffic. Hjalmarsson, fire wagon change there right in front of him, and so he must delay with Johnny Oduya stepping ahead and dropping it in.
What a beautiful pass there from Marcus Kruger. Right wing boards, left-handed shot on his backhand, and Frolik got to the center of the ice. All the Bruin players were mesmerized by Kruger and left Frolik all alone in front of Rask.
Well, Julian is telling his players right now, don't wait for the second period to wake up. Wake up right now. They're taking a play to you. And he's extremely demonstrative on the bench.
Hjalmarsson flipped that one along. Jagr forced it further. Bergeron takes it there. Rattled around for Marchand. Marchand stymied by Hjalmarsson. It's forced around behind, and again, it's Oduya to play. Bumped into by Jagr, taken on by Bergeron. Bergeron delays further, shoved off by Bolin. Strong defense by Bolin, matched by Bergeron. Coming by Jagr, poked from him by Oduya. Squirted further for Bickle to try to play out, and a good challenge from Boychuk. Jammed by Bickle, Boychuk back. Bergeron sets up, Ferentz with a shot, and it went wide. Forced along, but right into traffic from Oduya. Marchand dips the shoulder and tries to find room. There's none. Sweeps it to the back. Boychuk across. Ferentz with it there. Rifled one across. Marchand with it. Looking over the traffic. Deals it back. Boychuk a shot. A headhunter that actually did glance off Hjalmarsson. Meanwhile, it popped to the corner and is played back to Ferentz. Tries to keep the heat on, but this one has dropped back, and Bolin gets it to center. Oh, and then he's run into by Nicholas Boychuk. A drive, and that one went over the glove of the netminder Crawford. I knew better, but when that 55 comes up, you just have to see that there are two strong 55s in this league that deliver those hits. In this 1-0 Chicago lead.
Yeah, lots of talk whether or not Nathan Horton would be available here tonight after leaving back in game one in overtime. And boy, he's had a good start. He's made a couple of real good defensive plays. The offensive part of the game's been a little slow, but he's been really good in his own zone. He's been real active. He looks like he's comfortable. And a big lift for the Boston Bruins because he's so instrumental on the top line with Krejci and Lucic.
Nearly 7 minutes of playing time have passed without a Bruin shot. The last one came from Jagr, and that was before the 10-minute mark. Led along now for Seidenberg, who's able to twist a backhander along near Krejci. Stood up by Oduya. Right back along off of Saad. Goes back down, but there'll be no icing on this play. So Chara waits. Saad wanted to smoke him out, but Chara steps out anyway. Hands on to Krejci. Closed off and then escaped, and what have we? Something back glass. Down the ice. Some glass, apparently. Yeah. Or glass support.
One of the stanchions.
Speaking of that, let's go inside another pane of glass here with Pierre, brought to you by Bacardi.
Doc, what a phenomenal start for the Chicago Blackhawks. Big reason why, getting bodies to the net, trying to break down the Boston Bruins defense. Look at all the red sweaters. You got four of them right there. They're enveloping Tuukka Rask. Eventually, Patrick Sharp, he's going to throw that through amazing players. But you still have the big body of Hanzus right there. They're getting bodies to the net. It's clearly been part of their attack formula, and they're driving the Boston Bruins defenders nuts. 16-3 are the shots on goal. 1-0 is the score.
Both these teams have won six in a row in front of their home fans. They may be tweeting when that puck's dropped. Most of them will be watching. Things are settled. Glass support replaced. And Taves encroaches on the faceoff, and Krejci just drops away. Back in the batter's box. And a kick to Hjalmarsson. Oduya gives it back across to him. And directed back in. It'll be Seidenberg's puck to play. Swept along to Chara. Bruins hope to step out. Chara with the look. First pass important. Comes across to Horton. And Horton with a shot, but it winds up being an offside.
Both these teams, especially Chicago. Pierre talked about the net front presence so far for the Blackhawks. Forcing defensemen to turn and force them to skate back and get a forecheck going. Heard Mike and Jonesy talk a lot about that in game one. Try to sustain that forecheck, considering what both these teams went through a couple of nights ago. It made life really difficult on the other team's defense.
Good.
It is Johnny Boychuk to flip it along and back up the boards to Paye. Dealt on back to center. It is Letty taking over there. Sent back to him by Patrick Kane. Kane and Hanzus get the assists on the Sharp goal, the ninth of the playoffs for Patrick Sharp. This one from behind was knifed away from him by Kelly. And so it is taken by Letty and filtered on through for Sharp. Led back over, tucked across to Kane, drops it on back to Sharp, wide with the shot. Sent in front again, and Sharp tries the short side. This time it didn't work. And Sharp again with a shot, hit the outside of the cage. Turned to the outside now by Kane. Kane forced it across to Nick Letty. Dropped it back on for Patrick Sharp. Jammed one in front that's touched along by Ferentz. Settled down by Letty. With Hanzus there, a direction across. Sharp, a shot is saved by Rask. And jammed off the boards and back down, and it will go for an icing. The Bruins cannot make a change.
Eddie, this line's electrifying right now for Chicago. Kane, Sharp, and Hanzus, and they're dominating the Bruins defensemen with cycle, with poise, winning races, making good decisions, getting bodies to the net. What a touch pass from Hanzus to Patrick Sharp, and Rask shuts it down.
Scoring chances are 15-1 in favor of Chicago. In scoring chances, Sharp has five, one of which led to a goal. Heath tapped it on. Poked along by Kelly, thrown by Kruger, but that went off Boychuk. Floated on back now by Bolick, sealed up by Ferentz. Kruger is in, so also is Paye. Taken along by Kelly and lobbed on back. The Bruins want to get a change made, and they're able to do it now with that artful play by Kelly. So it's Seabrook laying it across, and Keith has trouble. Stepping back in with it now is Peverly. Peverly protects. Oh, and it's swatted away by Crawford. Hoisted on by Bolig to center.
No hesitation at all by Rich Peverly to take that puck right to the net. And a real good poke check there by Corey Crawford.
Keith handles there. And a long toss ahead that is carried back in by Hossa. Hossa with a shot turned aside by Rask. A big rebound came near Bolden, but pretty good defensive reflex by the Boston Bruins. Played along further by Hjalmarsson. That one is cut and started back out again by Tyler Seguin. Final minute of play in the first. Bickle forced it across. Yager with it there. Second effort. Able to push one that can be flagged down by Marchand. Steered on to Bergeron, who lobs it back in. Goes in with Hjalmarsson for it. Hjalmarsson prevailed to dump it along for Oduya. Yager won that one. Chipped one that is grabbed by Seidenberg at center and handed over to Chara and back in. So Oduya once more. Then Hjalmarsson. Must be settled down by Chara at center. Seidenberg ripped it back in. Marchand stepped to it there. Taves tried to knife it free. Close quarters got it on for Kane, and it's led on across for Oduya. 15 to go in the period, and the bouncer goes well wide. It's forced along by Taves, taken by Kane, filtered back to Taves, tried to pass to Kane again, but it's blocked with 3 seconds to go in the period. And Claude Julien was annoyed in the first. Still is, I am sure. And so there may be a paint peeler coming up. 19 shots to 4. 1 goal to none. Tuukka Rask important. Coming up on the Lexus Intermission Report, the Blackhawks sharp in the first period, plus the Bruins netminder, Tuukka Rask, who has been spectacular. And Corey Crawford as well moments ago. 10 minutes between shots for the Bruins. Not that long for the Blackhawks, including Patrick Sharp's 9th goal of the playoffs from Kane and Hanzus. 1-0 Hawks after 1. Stanley Cup Final on NBC is brought to you by Ford. Go further. By Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. And by Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. 1-0. Blackhawks fans and Blackhawks players were hoping for 2-0 on a play that we get to see from yet another angle.
Well, 12:32 of the first period. Jonathan Toews throws his puck to the front of the net, and the stick of Marian Hossa pushes the pads of Tuukka Rask. But watch what ends up happening. Check out the left part of your screen. The puck crosses the goal line. But the referee had blown the play dead prior to Marian Hossa pushing the goaltender's pads and the puck across the goal line. Once he loses sight of it, his intention is to blow the whistle. No goal, even though the puck crossed the goal line.
Two snarly guys are chased out of the faceoff, Taves and Krejci, and so it is Lucic and Saad and Chara. And directed on by Krejci, Lucic burrows in with Hjalmarsson. Saad through the legs pass, jammed on but into some traffic by Hossa, taken by Lucic behind. Flipped on but in the way is Taves, cleared one that can be followed up by Oduya and led back on to Taves again. Taves with a shot, and it went under the glove of Rask, but wide. Down went Hossa, across it sent, and it is Horton able to finesse it back in. Darting after it is Krejci with Hjalmarsson. They cross sticks, and then help came from Taves. Up for grabs and protected pretty well by Krejci, though it slipped through Lucic. Angled along for Hossa to help it along further for Saab. And back in. Boychuk connects back onto Marchand. Tried to step by. Slowed down there by Shaw. And wide of the reach of Rask. 6 shots by Sharp. 5 shots in the first period by Hossa. They were the most prominent, and Sharp was the one who registered a goal. Kicked on across now for Yager. Yager led it further, but off a Blackhawk stick, that of Keith. Couple of players go down, sliding in with Seabrook. Tumbling down is Boland, and a penalty for tripping is being called. And it is Boland who will head to the bench. Or will he go to the penalty box? No definitive call just yet. Looks like he's headed to the box, and the call is a trip on him.
Well, lots of bodies going down here on the initial forecheck right there. Looked like skate on skate with Bergeron and Seabrook, and then Boland and Marchand. I think you said why I oughta.
A lot of pest factor on the ice there. Marchand on the ice, Boland on the ice, and Shaw on the ice.
Well, an opportunity here for the Bruins, looking for some momentum. Totally dominated in that first period.
Chara with a shot that is blocked, as trying to direct it on for another power play goal with Bergeron. Oh, and a backhander is gonged away by Rask and taken by Chara. Oh,
good stop there by Rask and a real good play there by Frolik while shorthanded.
Lucic walks ahead and sped one. It's off Jágr, but protected pretty well for Jágr. Canceled out by Hossa. Battled free for Jágr. Backhands one in front that went off the skates of Lucic. And it's cleared back down. Bruins are 1-for-16 on their power play. The Blackhawks have killed off one of three in the series. Three of the last 29 have resulted in goals. So it was two kills for them out of three in game number one. Chicago, as Chara plays this one across and galloping on with it now, trying to finesse by, and doing so is Krejci. Wanted to center a pass, but wanting to and doing it, did not take into account Michael Frolik, who clears it out.
Fair to say, Eddie, Chicago looks much quicker in all facets of the game right now.
Yes.
Seabrook jabbed it along, and Oduya fed it back down the ice. No shots for the Bruins on this power play yet. That's got three quarters of a minute to go. Shots in the game are 20-4, Chicago. Drag back along. Trouble came there from Krejci, and it's called back on an offside.
Well, domination in a lot of areas back in that first period for the home team. Shots on goal. A few. Sharp with six, Hossa with five. And the Bruins with only four in that first period.
Greatest shot differential in the final was in 99, Dallas 19 and Buffalo 4. In game number two of that series, won by Dallas in six. Lucic nudges it ahead, and it's carried on now by Sagan, trying to work his way through. Got a shot on goal, and a pad stop was made by Crawford. No! Krug forced it around. Kruger steps to that one and blasts it back down the ice. 2 seconds and one. Out of the box, Boland. One shot on goal for the Bruins on the power play. Torrey Krug lugs one ahead and then throws it along. That went too far for Thornton. And icing is called. Picardi takes you inside the glass with Pierre.
Tuukka Rask has been amazing in this game so far. He's faced 20 shots. Sometimes prior preparation prevents potential problems. Tuukka Rask, that's his pregame warm-up routine. Watch this side-to-side action. Side-to-side again, denying Patrick Sharp right there. Side-to-side again, moving across, fighting through traffic, fighting off rebound opportunities. His lateral mobility and athleticism, phenomenal.
Barron stepped in the way of that one, starts it ahead, hoping for something good to happen from Paye. Does not this time, but Barron will try again. Peverly drops back to get in the sweep. Barron sees a defensive scheme set up ahead of him. That one ladled back in again by Kelly, played by Crawford. Letty with a second effort. Paye with a second effort as well. Gloved down by Boychuk. Out duels one of the Blackhawks, and then it's thrown on where Letty can one-hand it as far as center. Letty able to step on with it now. Sized up by the defender, Peverly. Flies and backhands one that's shut off by Rask, whose body is there. Oh, and he's able to stop the little backhander, too. His body was almost entirely over the line. But just the paraphernalia to make the stop was outside, and so no goal from that. Letty had it chopped away by Krejci. Protects again, harassed by Krejci. And Letty able to recover onto Roosevelt. Bruins a little more assertive in the forecheck, at least more successful with it here.
Looks like they got their skating legs a little bit more here in the second period.
Trouble for Seidenberg. Normally very sure-handed. Hossa walks back in and has it taken away by Krejci, but he's got it back again and sent one around in front. They jam for it. Reaching was Taves coming across Oduya. Pressed away right back for Hossa, but his pass is flagged and turned on to Horton by Krejci. To the back it comes to Oduya. More pressure here off Seidenberg, who rattles it on around hoping for Lucic. Didn't get him, but at least got it back down the ice, and there's no ice. Lucic hunts down Hjalmarsson, who plays on to Oduya. Long toss to Hossa. Delays and picks up a man on the wing, but the pass was blocked by Bergeron. Hunted down by Hossa, rushed away from him by the reach of Jaromir Jágr. Seabrook back. Chopped around by Bergeron. The battle on, and it's Seabrook able to tuck it on back further, and Duncan Keith. Slowed down there by Bergeron, taken on by Jágr, and a shot is blocked up high and out of play by Crawford.
Quick little turnover in the middle of the ice, and Jaromír Jágr, who gets this puck. Good play there by Patrice Bergeron from our Grand Royal RoboCam. Easy save there for Corey Crawford off the blocker.
Now, Nick Leddy's got tremendous skating ability, and he takes advantage of a forward, Rich Peckerly, playing defense, and he almost gets it to the front of the net. Eventually, Sharks going to get another chance, and Tuukka Rask shuts it down.
Well, Peckerly did a good job there, the forward skating backwards, as Pierre mentioned. Foreign territory for a forward like that, especially when you have one of the quicker players on the other side coming down at you. Everly did a good job of keeping him to the outside.
Quick work done here. Boy, that was fast by the Blackhawks ice crew. Good for them. Saturday, August 17th, NBC, NBC Sports Network. Become the new home for the Barclays Premier League. And for the first time ever, watch every match every week live on TV and online. The Barclays Premier League beginning Saturday, August 17th. From the rugby scrum, Roosevelt outreach Paille. Fed across by Frolik. Knocked free by Sagan. Goes in with Leddy. Forced up the board. Poichuk blasts one that careened onto Sagan. Fed one that was flagged down by Kruger, and Kruger is able to settle things down. The Bruins with six shots. Two of them by Jágr. This is carried right back on to Frolik. Frolik with a shot. Oh, and that one is blocked wide. Up the boards, it can be played again. Thrown back across by Kelly. Trying to pull free, but unable to do it that time was Horton. And then jammed back.
Good play by Duncan Keith there. It looked like Horton had something going, trying to cut back from the outside to the inside with a good active stick.
Carried right back on, and it's Kruger's shot that's blocked away by Seidenberg. Seidenberg mashes into Kruger, dragged along by Hossa. Back to Keith for a shot, and that one blocked down. Bouncer, Saad with a shot, and that one cut off by Chara. Brushed on back, and it's yanked on across for further control by Keith. And the Bruins very tight with their checking right now, and that caused this to be freed off of Krejci and back down. Jágr two shots, Sagan two shots, rest of the team two shots. But it's only a one-goal game. Nearing the middle point of this contest now. If it's a normal game. Something we did not see in game number one. Offside pass. Stops the clock with 12:36 to go. In period number two, 21 shots to six. Blackhawks, the narrowest of scores to even have one.
Well, we heard Mike Milbury talk about Jaromír Jágr in that first intermission. It's probably time for Claude Julien to change up his lines, to jumpstart his team if he's looking to ignite them. They're only down one, but if they're looking to get some offense going, get some players going, you got to change up your lines.
Leddy a shot, and that one blocked away by Rask. Kicked along now for Bergeron, left behind on the backhand and turning with it. And forehanding it along is Johnny Boychuk. Off a linesman's skate, dug out but knifed ahead conveniently for the carry on by Bergeron. Led to the back for Ferentz to try to reconnect with Bergeron, but off his stick to Kane. 7:50 play, second period, 22 shots for Chicago, and six for Wallace. Jágr got a pass across Stipley, Marchand doubles back, but by then it's headed the other way. And carried by Patrick Kane and fed across for a little tip there that came from Bergeron, slugged behind by Leddy. And Sharp is able to emerge with that. The puck is finding Patrick Sharp tonight, and a penalty has been drawn on his hustle. A power play to Chicago. Johnny Boychuk will sit.
Everything in red is quicker than everything in white right now. Even though Boston's trying to push the pace, Eddie, it directly leads to this penalty by Johnny Boychuk. Red sweater's winning races.
Yeah, got body position there on Boychuk. Sharp felt the arm, sold the call, and power play opportunity. Oh,
0 for the prior one for Chicago. Two shots on their first power play that went on goal. Seabrook could not reach until now.
Sorry, Doc. Usually when you're standing still and reaching, the next step is into the penalty box, and that's exactly what happened to Boychuk.
Boy, Keith with a lot of work to gain the line. Shaw played it on. Taves tried to get further. Kelly had an opening, and Beverly was ready to break. Beverly able to nudge it out, and Kelly can carry it on and then lob it back in. Beverly and Paille are the penalty-killing forwards. Seidenberg and Chara in back. Weaving his way along and taking his own little push pass is Taves. Led to the back to Seabrook. Jammed back on off of Taves. Checked there by Chara, and it's fed back down by Paille. First one there is going to be Krejci, who nudged it behind. Paille is hammered by Seabrook, and Seabrook comes up with this.
Oh, Keith did a really good job on David Krejci, not allowing him to pass that puck to the front of the net to Daniel Paille.
Motoring on is Kane, trying to dance free, brushed away by Ferris. Scaled on back for the hold by Sherp and a shot, and that one blocked by McQuaid, and he clears it back down. A shotless power play so far that has 37 to go in it. Accelerating ahead now is Letty. Letty had it knifed away. Can be played on further. The Bruins have blocked a dozen Chicago shots. The Blackhawks have having to need to block only one of Boston so far. And then it is lost by Beverly, flipped by Letty, gloved by Ferentz, kept by Sod. Worked back one again for a little feed in front for Kane that's wandered away by Ferentz, settled down by Sod, has Roosevelt fresh from the bench. Roosevelt led it over, Kane with it there. 3 seconds and two. Boland over to Kane. Kane with a shot. It's blocked away before it could get to the cage. Settled down by Kelly and played back out. Boychuk will go back for this. And there is icing. Penalty box empty. Still 1-0 Chicago.
Talked about that play. David Krejci on Duncan Keith to the right of Corey Crawford coming all the way back. Look at Krejci. Does a great job of looking to see what his options are. And then that's the way you defend a one-on-one. Got a lot of young hockey players out there, young defensemen. Get your stick on the ice, get it in the passing lane. If your stick's up in the air, you have no chance of denying that. And Duncan Keith's made two really good plays here in period two, just like that.
It is Seidenberg taking over defensively for the Bruins. And off a glass support, not the repaired one, put it off another one, and back in. Jalmerson to step forward with this. Bounce to Chara, fed back out again. In close quarters, Horton to Lucic, and he gains some space. Lucic holds and delays, and then threw one that was blocked off by Saw. Jabbed on back again, Krejci trying to play that. Shoved off by Oduya. Bouncing puck, and Sod is smeared there by Boychuk. Meanwhile, carrying it back ahead is Taves. Gave it to Hossa. Save made by Rath. Floated back on, and now it is Horton. Let it back across, and galloping on is Lucic. Tried to poke it on through. Still battles and gets some help from Krejci. Krejci twists the pass over to Lucic. He's able to play it, but away from Horton, and so it will be Bickel. A lot of effort there by Krejci on that chip. This one's played around behind and paddled away by Crawford with 8.5 to go.
Lucic with a big hit on Andrew Shaw, who made the play, took a hit, made the play to get the puck out.
Poked right to the slot. Shaw shot that is blocked wide. Good job done there by Krug for the Boston defense. Around behind McQuaid. Reverse to Krug. Harassed by Bickel. Krug escapes again, nearly run to the ditch by Shaw. Lucic cannot clear, but help came by Bergeron to push it farther out.
Lucic needs to get off. He's out of gas.
He does come off now as this one's rattled back in with under 8 minutes to go in the second. Shaw backhands it behind. Bickel waiting for it there. Hands to Seabrook. Punched on where a stick is stray from Shaw. And it's grabbed off by Yager and blistered back in. Paille trying to get there first, but it's Seabrook instead. No icing. Played back up the board. More hard work done by Kelly, but it's Bickel's cross-bodied by Paille, brought back ahead by Frolik, errant pass, and it's Boychuk. Blackhawks in the midst of a change, and turning with this is Roosevelt. and directed off a Bruin out of play, no penalty. 7:28 to go. Second period, 1-0 Chicago. He is 6 feet 4, 220, Milan Lucic.
You're only down by one, but it looks like they're dictating the terms. What have they done to your team?
Well, we got caught playing on our heels in the first period. They just took charge of the game, and we're a little bit better skating in the second period, but we're really not managing that puck well. A lot of turnovers, and even offensively, nothing's coming out of it. So we got to relax a little bit, find our game here, and we're lucky it's just a 1-0 game. We can get ourselves back into it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, I would agree with that assessment as far as the skating part. It looks like they do have a little bit more jump in their step, but only two shots on goal. Got to get the puck in just like that and get to work.
Letty's pass. Oh, and Roosevelt run into by Kelly, who's been very aggressive tonight. Sagan handed this one on back. Boychuk handed it on across.
Doc and Eddie, Chris Kelly's been one of the more vocal leaders for the Boston Bruins so far in this game, really challenging his teammates to be better.
An intercept, and it's carried on by Sharp. Patrick Sharp jammed one that ricocheted off a skate. Bounced across for Kelly. Nudged on, and Sharp curled back in, but that wound up being an offside. Tomorrow, golf's best compete for America's National Championship live from Majestic Marion Golf Club in Philadelphia. The U.S. Open continues tomorrow at 12 Eastern on NBC in the town of Ardmore. This is the leaderboard. As you study that, we'll tell you that in the American Hockey League playoffs, Grand Rapids won the first three games, and now Syracuse will take the series back home, having won the next two, including 5-2 tonight in Grand Rapids. It's the Syracuse team that was Tampa Bay's farm team, located in Norfolk a year ago, and they won it all. Hossa nudge there. It's floated on a cross and can be grabbed and carried out by Seidenberg, and he backhands it in. Racing back is Horton. Jalmerson sees it flipped away from him. Nudged on now for Chara, who pinched along further. Got it around behind. Horton got it to the front of the net. It's played off by Chara. Reaching for it, Lucic, knife from him, and so it's Oduya. Krejci tries to get in the way of this. Kareem back to Taves. Got it on a cross. And it's Oduya, who has played a lot. Oh, my, was he ever walled by Lucic.
He's had two of those hits here in the last 3 minutes of ice time. Lucic on Shaw earlier, and then that one on Oduya.
There's an angry bunch of Bruins right now. This one floated on back and wandered away to the corner by McQuaid, who goes back and doubles up with Mickel. Dives and plays it on to Krug, but up the wall it's held by Seabrook. Dealt on back now for Shaw, tried to jam it to the front. Sean Marsh on tangle. Across near Biffle, rescued and thrown back out by McQuaid. Shaw and Marchand are having a little bit of a duel. Rattled on around and turning for it is Shaw. Roughed up a bit by Krug. The board's now taken by Jonker. Moving out with Marchand. Feeds it across to Krug. He steps ahead. Krug trying to get by and hurried one in front that is blocked and covered. Crawford did that. Shots are 23-7. Blackhawks in the lead in goals, 1-0. Welcome back to the Stanley Cup Final presented by Geico, the majestic skyline of the city of Chicago.
19-4 in the first period, shots on goal in favor of the Blackhawks here in the second period. 4-3.
Though on goal, that one is not posted as a shot on goal yet. And this is rolled around behind by Sharp, but taken by Paille. Dances free out in front, trying to put one. They score! Paille rushed from behind the net. Got one shot that was blocked, and Kelly, who has been a whirling dervish out here physically, has been able to mash home the tying goal.
Play below the goal line, and the quick little move by Daniel Paille. Watch this move right here. He goes past Nick Letty, takes the puck hard in net, and Chris Kelly comes right in. and puts his puck past Corey Crawford.
What a nice pinch by Andrew Ferris. That allows a forecheck game for the Bruins to get engaged. You're right about Pye, and then Kelly, who is backing up Ferris on the pinch, does a great job finding a dead spot in coverage. It's total team play for the Bruins there. They needed a surge. The most vocal Bruin tonight has been Kelly. The most aggressive Bruin has been Kelly, and he gets rewarded with a goal.
Pye, Kelly, and Sagan on the ice together.
And Sagan got the second assist. Of course, Pye with the first. Thornton goes after this one. Peverly got there, tried to reach Thornton. Instead, it was Keith. Tipped on a cross, and Crew shovels one that's blocked back out again by Zebra.
And a little line adjustment there by Claude Julien. With Pye, Kelly, and Sagan, he's rewarded. And his team is on the board.
And a lot of speed on that line already. That makes a big difference if you want to get a forecheck game going.
Brought back on by Seabrook and blasted wide. Struck the back of the cage before it is played behind further. Chipped on to Brolik. Wants to step further, but he's mashed down a couple of times there by Thornton to the back. Oduya shot blocked away by McQuaid. Oduya sent it around behind, turning with it as Brolik. Escapes and spun one across that net mouth wide. 4 minutes to go. Second period in the game, tied at one. Again, back up the boards, turned back out by Dogovins, and back down, and it will go for an icing touch-up.
Krug with a cross-check to the back of Jonathan Toews. As that puck was sent down the other way. Face-off to the left of Tuukka Rask.
Offensive zone face-off for the Blackhawks coming up. It was 2 years ago tonight. The Bruins won Game 7 in Vancouver, 4-0 shutout for Tim Thomas, who was presented with the Conn Smythe, the oldest Conn Smythe winner at 37 at that time. Forced back off, and Seabrook chopped it, but out of play. There'll be no penalty there. Just the face-off to center ice.
With the start in the first period by the Blackhawks, it was just inevitable that they would come down from being so high and so forceful in that first period. They haven't been able to really sustain or generate a whole heck of a lot here in the second period.
Oftentimes the big players cancel, and it is left to the third and fourth liners to make a difference. But as you have pointed out, Claude Julien with one alteration on the right side. And the work and time that has been earned by Pye and Kelly. And it ties the game. Meanwhile, it's forced around behind, trying to escape to the front. No luck there for Hossa. Comes back up the boards, protected by Jalmerson. Twists it right back in deep. It's Toews around behind. Fed one to the slot, but that flagged and carried right back out again by Krejci. Moving back up. Crosses. Fed one on over for Horton. Oh! One was blocked away. On out to center, it can be raced back in by Saad. Taken out of the play by the now helmetless Seidenberg. There will be a tripping call on him.
Nathan Horton shoots one wide. That leads to a quick counter opportunity for Brandon Saad. He wins a race because Chara pinched out. Seidenberg has to move from his right to his left. Great speed by Brandon Saad. Seidenberg has to take the penalty there.
Well, back at the other end, here's David Krejci, but the play is made because of Milan Lucic driving hard, and that will open up the lane for Krejci to get this puck over to Nathan Horton. Right there. And I think Horton was in between. I think he wasn't sure if he should shoot or pass because Lucic went right to the net. It was in between, and then the puck came all the way back the other way, and Pierre showed exactly what happened there with the speed of Saad and the penalty by Seidenberg.
Power play is 0-for-2 with just two shots. And it will get recoiled with the tap from Crawford to Sharp. Kane is out there amongst the Blackhawks now as it's brought ahead by Liddy, given on to Hanzus, then to Sharp. Off Hanzus, pawed at by Ferris. Coming by was Boychuk. Away from Boland, on back to Liddy. And that one blocked and steered out further by Marchand. And then off the stick of Bergeron, can be played on to Liddy, who turns but right into the path of Bergeron. So strong defensively, he comes to the bench for a change. The first 40 seconds uneventful. Carried back on by Hanzus and given to Boland again. Jammed for Hanzus, carried off and up by Ferris. Then it must be played to Kane. rattled on around to Sharp again. Right back for Patrick Kane once more. Likes to shoot from there, but will he this time? Answer no. It is Boland yet again. Boland, a shot, save made by Rask. Rebound fiddled in front by Kane and trapped by Rask.
No hesitation at all. As Boland comes all the way over and takes his puck from Patrick Kane. He just fires it right to the front of the net. There's Hanzus. And then Kane throws it right back to the front of the net. And Rask does a really good job of finding that puck, not giving up a second chance.
Get pucks on goal. Smart idea. Keep it simple. And Tuukka Rask, big as a house for Boston.
Krejci on this tie-up with Taves. It's squirted on back to be held by Keith and given on to Hossa. 52 to go on this power play. Hossa let it back, and then his stick has broken. Dug out by Chara, tried to float it along, and with the broken stick adding to the confusion, and now without one is Kelly. It comes back to center.
Kelly's broke as well, Doc.
Two on one play as it's led back over to Keith. Fires it back across. Out of all the chaos, it escapes on over to Paille. Paille puts on the brakes and then slams it, and it goes as far as center. No shots yet by the Blackhawks on this power play with 20 seconds to go, and a nice block there by Paille. Sent it too far for Marchand. Can he get there? Marchand in front. Oh, and he hit the post with a shot! And it in net is dislodged, and play is stopped.
The Bruins are livid. They can't believe there wasn't a penalty called on Seabrook for the slash on Marchand. He did get a chance on goal, though.
Daniel Paille stops that puck and throws it up into an area. Brad Marchand skates into it. Left part of your screen. Here comes Seabrook. Right there to slash across the hands. And what an opportunity for Brad Marchand.
As Doc and Eddie like to say, not even a shot on goal. Just off the post.
Crawford could say he had it all the way, but it doesn't ring up as a save for him either. Just for the iron. And this is Jalmerson.
1 minute.
In the final minute of the second period. Saad and then Poikin. Tough one for Oduya. Trips up Marchand and a penalty will be called.
I know you're in trouble when both guys get their hand up at the same time. O'Halloran and Ed McCauley both. Aggressive play by Boychuk. Hammers the puck around the boards, Eddie.
Well, Pierre's talking about Johnny Boychuk going back. But the understanding of where this puck is going and Brad Marchand's able to get there, that's the key. Good pressure by Kruger. Puck takes a bad bounce, and then Oduya trying to get the puck, yet skates. Penalty called. If he doesn't get him, it's a two-on-one because Seidenberg was coming out of the penalty box. Would have been a clear-cut two-on-one from the blue line in.
Led to the back now for Yager to give across to Krug. Empty on one power play opportunity with a shot on goal on that one are the Bruins as Sagan steps in. He has Krug to his right, and that's where he'll go. Has Yager and gives to him. Yager with a shot and turned aside by Crawford. Fed onto the back again. Krug to Yager, another shot saved by Crawford.
Eddie, you played with Jaromir Jagr. You know his game as well as anybody. I don't think that's what he likes to do. One time, it's not his thing.
Yeah, he just liked to get it and wrist it right at the goaltender. Good movement by the Bruins. Jagr gets it. That's the type of shot that he likes to make. But to Pierre's point, he doesn't have... doesn't look comfortable when he's taking those one-time opportunities.
Never been a strength of his game. He's got a lot of strengths. That's not one of them.
Stolen there and protected pretty well, ragging it free of Sagan. Sagan delays and throws it onto the back, and it could not be stopped by Jagr, so they'll go back now in the last five. Long toss ahead to Lucic, and the horn sounds. Coming up on the Discover Card Intermission Report, Liam, Mike, and Keith. Sharp play continues for the Blackhawks, plus the Bruins' bruising play pays off. In that period, four shots for Chicago, eight for Boston. Both teams with a goal after the first 40 minutes. You thinking what I'm thinking? The Stanley Cup Final on NBC is brought to you by Bacardi. Bacardi reminds you to enjoy the game and party together responsibly. By Lexus and the Pursuit of Perfection. And by Verizon, the official wireless partner of the NHL. Chris Kelly has scored for Boston, and that man Patrick Sharp for Chicago. Hockey is family. Take a look at this. Abby Sharp holding up not quite 1.5-year-old Madeline Grace in her Hawks jersey for Patrick to see during a warm-up. Years from now, she'll be a graduate like young Samuel Flood was today. And so many others have been in these weeks of June. Congratulations to all the graduates. Thoughts with Blackhawk family and fan members Rochelle Rockwin, Richard Swanson, and recovering Bruin Gregory Campbell. The quiet before the chaos of the third. A power play for Boston, and you mentioned the fatigue at the very beginning of the night. Assess it now.
Well, it looked like in the first period, the Bruins did not have their skating legs. Chicago had it, and then the second period looked like Chicago lost it, and the Bruins were getting better as the second period went on. See who has it here in the third.
There have been two shots on goal by the Bruins in the second period part of this power play. Chara fed one back and had to hurry to take it because of Kruger, and then had to avoid him, and sweeping away was Frolik. So back ahead it is Milan Lucic with 10 hits in this game. And play is stopped.
And a couple of huge ones in that second period. One on Andrew Shaw, one on Johnny Oduya. Talk a lot about Lucic when he's going straight ahead. There are not many guys in the league that can stop him when he's going straight ahead.
10 hits, and the entire Hawks team has had 13. Blasted along by Roosevelt. Kept for a moment by Char, but now he drops back as it's led up the wing, shorthanded to Hossa, and denied by Sagan. Another strong defensive play by the forward Tyler Sagan. This one carried back on now by Lucic, has to be followed up by Sagan with 27 to go on the power play, and the Hawks in the midst of a change. It's Jágr trying to finesse his way by. That one is not from him. Jágr with four shots on goal through two periods, three of them in the second. Marchand led it over. Krejci tries to work his way in, but lost it off of Duncan Keith's skate.
Couple of good plays through the middle of the ice for the Blackhawks. Keith there, as you mentioned, Doc. Taves had one a little bit earlier.
Krejci trying to keep this, but cannot. Prolik moves on. Oduya out of the box, and the shot ricocheted wide off of Seidenberg. Krug outlets it on. A 1-1 tie, third period. Nothing much at stake here. It's an even series, or the Bruins will be forced to win four out of the next five. We have another championship. This one lofted on out to center and can be controlled and angled on back, where it's shanked in by Horton, taken by Keith, given to Jalmerson, rifled off the boards to Ferentz. Ferentz with the blast back in. Delayed offside is wiped. It's an onside play, but it's the Blackhawks who have it. Then Boland, then Jalmerson, then Boland, escaping Kelly, fires a shot, and it went wide of the cage and can be brought back out and carried on by Beverly. Led back up the wing, trying to shake through with Paye, canceled out by Seabrook, dumped around behind, and that one went away from Beverly and back out to center. 2.25 played in the third. Two shots for the Blackhawks, none yet for the Bruins. Kane shooting one that's blocked down there by Seidenberg. The shot blocking specialist, and so good with the puck in his skates. That old Germanic soccer tradition comes to the fore when he is able to advance it that way. Don't need a stick for that. Rushed on out to him at center. And he drifts a pass onto Lucic. Gaining the zone, rifling a pass across. Trouble for Horton. Dug out and twisted by Krejci, but right into the path of Duncan Keith. Krejci comes back again and is able to control. To the back to Ferentz, a shot. It's covered by Crawford.
Well, a real scrambly play in front of Corey Crawford, and he finally gets that last shot and takes a whistle. Krejci trying to throw this puck back door. Good stick there by Nathan Horton off the giveaway from Duncan Keith. And then Krejci finds that puck, and no second chance off the shot from Ferentz.
Really good awareness by Corey Crawford to make sure there was no second chance opportunity.
So Seabrook takes this one, hunted down by Bergeron, off the stick of Marchand, retrieved by Chara to the glove of Marchand and back to the big man at 6'9". Seidenberg gave it to him again, and it bounced off his stick. Jágr deals it across. Seidenberg banked it out. Dealt by Bergeron, escaping is Jágr. Jágr fed one on a cross. Oh, and a save made by Crawford. Remarkable stop on Marchand. Saad brings it back. Wipes out. Loose puck knifed away. With a good accurate move by Seidenberg from the reach of Taves. Jágr ladled it ahead, tried to get there. Gently bumped down, turns and glares back at the referee for a non-call. And it's forced back in by Oduya. Torrey Krug to get it there, dumped it around behind. Kruger has stood up. Meanwhile, it comes on to Jalmerson. Floats it along, hoping for Kruger again. Marcus Kruger spins, deals it on back for Oduya. Fed it back across to Jalmerson. Quick challenge from Sagan. And it is Seidenberg. Then Boley. Off Paye. And Paye flexed it behind. Seidenberg will try the other side. Plenty of help there, but it's not cleared out. Oduya kept play moving. Rattled it around to Krug's side. Fired away from Kruger and back down. And it will go for an icing. The Bruins will not be allowed to get the change they would like.
Good shift for the fourth line of the Blackhawks after a A-plus chance for the Bruins. Jaromír Jágr winds it up from our Crown Royal, RoboCamp, Patrice Bergeron. Right part of your screen is Brad Marchand. Beautiful forehand, backhand. Tries to go upstairs, doesn't get it. Up and up at Corey Crawford with another glove stop. But the speed of Jágr through the middle of the ice created that play.
Led on back for Keith's shot that would not go through. Seidenberg in the way once more, and it's cleared back down in a race on. Crawford needs to have it over that line, and it just did, and now he duels with Sagan, who tries to kick it in front, but it's Seabrook with it there. Dogged work by Tyler Sagan, comes on back, fed across for a shot by Krejci that's turned aside by Crawford. Remarkable shift for Sagan, who will come to the bench for a replacement, but before he does, he's got to knock it down and clear it back in. Makes sense. Crawford hooked it along, played there by Seabrook. Rattled on off the stick of Hossa and back down, and it will go for an icing.
The speed of Paye and Sagan really affect Corey Crawford in this situation. Doc talked about it. That's the triangle that Corey Crawford's got to watch out for. He'll take a penalty. Sagan tries to keep the play alive. Eventually, they force a turnover. Great aggressive play by Lucic. Sagan and Krejci, and a chance on Crawford.
If Krejci prevails, it will likely be directly behind him to Lucic. Horton will be up front alongside Saad. Lucic got there, not the way they planned, but still did. Walled by Seabrook. Sent on back to Chara, helped across. Seidenberg, one-timer, and a save made by Crawford. Inside the glass, Bacardi and Pierre.
Little push by the Bruins right now to start the third. Big reason why this push is happening. Teamwork in the second period. Chris Kelly, Andrew Ferentz, look at 23 and white. He's a forward. He knows Ferentz is going to pitch down, so now he's on the point. That engages a forecheck. Paye with some skill. Sagan to the net. Kelly on the rebound. That's the epitome of what the Bruins are all about. Teamwork.
One by Krejci. Seidenberg gives to Chara. Hurried shot blocked down in front. As standing there was Jalmerson. Back ahead comes Saad. Watched by Chara. Backhander is grabbed and held by Rask. In the first period, the scoring chances were 16-2 Chicago. In the last 25 minutes, 10-2 Boston.
You've called Milan Lucic's name a lot, Doc, but the effort on the back check, putting pressure on Brandon Saad here to make a quick play from the outside. You're not only worrying about 6'9" Zdeno Chara, you also got to worry about the back pressure. But Brandon Saad, the guy that took that shot on that last rush, had an outstanding game. It plays like that back in game one. And giving your defenseman some help.
Off the tie-up, it is reached by Seidenberg and played second effort to Chara. And finessed on for Peverley, but it hopped away from him at center. Chopped on for Kane, but Peverley recoiled. Got it back again from Seidenberg, and now the Bruins can move straight ahead until they get near Kane. Sharp rifles it back in again. He had one shot in the second period after getting six in the first and the goal. Ferentz led it on. Beverly sent it further. Gogovin's tried to brush it further. Good work done by Thornton there. Tumbling down to the ice a second time is Letty. Now he's without a helmet. Must feel cool out there. Punched right back down. Not safe, but at least get a momentary bit of cool air. Brought back on now by Ferentz. And rifled all the way back down the ice, and it will go for last icing. Watch live NBC National games on NHL Game Center. Call *NHL to download NHL Game Center. Get a free premium upgrade on all tablets and Verizon 4G LTE smartphones.
Yeah, icing shooting the puck from your side of the red line, from your defensive side of the red line without touching anybody, all the way down past the goal line at the opposing goaltender. That's where you get icing.
Keith a shot, and that knockdown and reaching for it was Taves. He was hoping for the tip. Rolled off that one and angled it on back for Keith again. Fed back to the outside, Saad turning. Gives it back to Keith, and his shot was stifled by Yager and then sailed on back where Keith set it down at center. Tried to finesse through Yager. No luck there. Puck free, and Yager finds it and then hands back on to Bergeron. Defended away by a couple of Blackhawks. And it started back up by Shaw. Shaw trying to escape Bergeron's reach and does. Chopped that from behind by Marchand. And then Marchand stepped into him after he let that shot go. Chara has it kicked away by Boland and fired around behind. Seidenberg tries to play it there. Rolled off the hip, got it onto Chara. Two big men out there for the Bruins right now. A little bit fatigued. Chara has this one and Sky hooks it onto center.
What a play by Seidenberg. Ryan to protect that puck and eat it and then move it over. Not an easy play to make.
You got to understand where you are and know the situation.
And also know you're likely going to get hit, so brace yourself. Hjalmarsson able to motor along and fire one that went off the stick of Kelly. Retrieved by Bolick. The big man got it around behind. Bounced on back near Bolick. Taken to the outside by Frolik. Hunted down by Kelly. Frolik able to circle there. Spins one that's blocked away by Tuukka Rask. Hunched on back now to Bolick. Shot one that was blocked down by Kelly. And back in deep it goes to be scaled along to Frolik. Watched by Paille. Led it to the back. Roosevelt there. Frolik a shot. And that one rattled wide as it was steered off by Seidenberg. Now Bolling behind. Off of Seidenberg. Dug out there but handed right over to Paille. And so he and Kelly in a two-on-two. Drift, crisscross, and it's played back in where Paille was effectively screened off by Letty.
Another good shift for the fourth line of the Blackhawks. Bolling. Frolik, Kruger. A lot of their play offensively has been below the goal line behind Tuukka Rask.
Brought on by Bolick and backhanded in. Came along to Ferentz. Trying to hit him with Shaw. Got the glass, which sometimes will happen. Driven by Bickle, and that one turned away by Ferentz. And then sent by Lucic. There is a stick on the ice. There's a stray glove out there. A garage sale at United Center. Blocked on by Boychuk. Taken to the neutralized area by Bickle. And Bickle will just draw it back in. There's another stick stray out there. Can you guys clean up after yourselves?
We've got an aisle six.
Carried on now by Yager. Yager dragging it on further. Puts on the brakes. Let it on back. Chara shot. Save made by Crawford. 10:33 to go. A tense third period tied at one. Monday night, the 2013 Stanley Cup Final presented by Geico moves to Boston. Game three, Blackhawks and Bruins. Coverage starts with NHL Live at 7 Eastern right here on NBC Sports Network. Bergeron wins, Seidenberg with it. Deals it to the corner and the bounce favors Marchand, but he was canceled out by Keith. Yager with a stick that has failed him. A lot of that going on here in the third period. A chance out in front, unable to pull the trigger on the shot that time was Marchand. Played on out to center. Beg your pardon, that was Bergeron right near the front of the net with Marchand. And Bergeron let it go as he does here. Knife down by Marchand off the stray stick of Yager. Worked on by Marchand, but then it is sent back out where it can be controlled back in now and forced on by Shaw. Good body position, and then Shaw tied up enough by Bergeron that it can be lugged out by Yager and fed across and in stride to take that one as Krug. He gains the zone, gets reinforcements from the bench, and it's sent around behind.
Little changing of lines by Joel Quenneville. He's got Taves and Kane on the ice now.
A steal left behind, though, and Taves on to Kane. Bothered all the way by Kelly. Kelly took the puck, handed it back. Seidenberg then to Chara. Oblivious of the referees in the stands, it is thrown across off the stick of Sagan and jammed around by Oduya. Some trouble came there as Roosevelt has to double back. Settles it down this time and is met again by Sagan. Pitched on off the stick of Saad and back short of icing so the Blackhawks can get a change of their own. A little over 9 minutes to go. Third period, 1-1. Getting back to his feet from that hit is Paye. The puck skipped right past him, though, and can be started back up by Boldy. Off of Prolique, carried on by Kruger, across to Letty, and Letty is forced around behind with the dogged defensive work being done there by one of the Bruins. This one is forced on out to center. The Bruin who did that was Sean Thornton. Directed right back in on Rask, and Rask will just hang on and get the stoppage of play.
Getting nervous yet?
1-1 in the third.
Tough start all the way around for the Bruins in period one and for Jaromir Jagr, but as this game has gone on, he's found his skating legs, creating a couple of great chances, skating strong, making plays, being creative offensively. It has taken the elder statesman on the Bruins a little bit of time to get his legs going.
Popped along near Bergeron, jabbed toward the corner by Marian Hossa. Taves worked on there defensively by Bergeron. It's squipped up to Lucic, tried to tap it on. Bergeron came by, able to jam it on into the legs of Horton, and it's trickled back in.
Eddie Hossa had to go to the room to get his skate work on.
Oh, here's a chance, but then unable to find the handle. Horton rushed along and taken by Lucic, waits on the blast, got it over to Horton, delays, and then peels off and hooks for Krejci behind. Got what he wanted there. Krejci angles it on. Seidenberg takes the net, thrown off a glass support. A strange sort of bounce, but which one of them isn't tonight? Bounced along now near Seidenberg. Play continues. No hand pass is ruled alertly by the referee, Wes McCauley. Jammed on to center where it is shut off by Krejci. Tries to march back in. No luck. Hossa challenged by Krejci. Turned over to Lucic. Along off the stick, stiffly of Horton, and he will drop back. Shift change on for the Bruins. Seidenberg blasted back in, and they can get the rest of the guys off as Shaw stepped into him. Right from the bench, a hurried shot by Krug is grabbed and held by Crawford.
Now you're a defenseman. You're going back for the puck. You're Nicholas Jalmerson. You're going back here. You can't see anything to this side. So why are you going to try to make a backhand pass to the middle of the ice? That play can't happen. That goes right over the stick of David Krejci. The trust factor, yes, the centerman is there, but when you start making no-look blind passes on the backhand to the middle of the ice, usually that puck ends up in the back of your net.
Seabrook and Keith are the defensemen. Hanzus is out there along with Sharp and Kane. Rask tapped it aside. Ferentz up the boards. Right there is Sagan. Tumbles down, but Bergeron able to weave one for Marchand, but off his stick and Keith. Rushed back in by Bergeron. Boy, what a hawk. He is in a Bruins uniform here, being right near the puck almost all the time. He sweeps back for Keith. Deflected up high. Chipped on back by Ferentz. Keith will go back to get it and take the icing. 6:50 to go in the third.
A lot of guys really digging deep right now because of the three overtime game in game one. And you can see the fatigue factor starting to set in. Eddie, I don't know when you play, if you went through anything like that, but this has got to be really tough on all these players.
Yeah, you just find a way. The adrenaline carries you for a long period of time.
Trouble for Sharp there in handling that. Bergeron tried to nudge it ahead, and Sharp challenged it back. And then it is forced on in by McQuaid.
Talked about shift lengths at the start of this game. Now it's almost saying that both teams are going up and down and off. 15, 20 seconds. Make sure that you change before you're tired. Chicago won't be able to change here as the Boston Bruins touch up and a face-off to the right of Corey Crawford.
Oh, you can sense it down here, both benches. I mean, the fatigue factor's clearly kicked in. Joel Quenneville knows it. Claude Julien knows it.
The Bruins players are digging deep. The Blackhawks players are digging deep. And I think we're finding out that game one was not as easy as maybe some people wanted to tell you after game one was over.
On goal and covered by Crawford. Well, you gentlemen coached. I don't know if you ever wound up in a long game like this one, but both coaches told us today they were really tired the day after because they're walking all the time, they're standing, and more importantly, they're having to concentrate on orchestrating line changes. Claude Julien talked about being very conscious of the overtime and the 10-minute mark because that's when everybody gets a break for the ice to be redone. And off the tie-up, that one is waffle-boarded away by Crawford.
You got to be one step ahead of everybody else when you're standing behind that bench.
Behrens banked it on, and it went on through. No icing on this play. Hanzus around behind. Led it on across for the carry-up by Johnny Oduya. Took the hit, threw it off the mesh from center. Neutral ice, a face-off. Tomorrow, golf's best compete for America's National Championship live from Majestic Marion Golf Club in Philadelphia. The U.S. Open continues tomorrow at 12 Eastern on NBC. Johnny Oduya said last night, or check that this morning, about the game, game number one, he said a lot of guys ate bananas just for energy during the overtime intermission. I did not because I was worried about cramping, but they have all kinds of specialty drinks. One is a coconut-flavored drink that guys can have that will immediately replenish fluids and give you some protein and some energy. Bouncer came on ahead and jammed on back and saw it there. May have to do that again tonight. Who will know? 5:45 to go in the third, and we're tied at one. Tipped along by Lucic. Tangled up in his skates for a moment. Hossa there. And out of quite a scrum, it went off of Lucic, but is carried back up by Krejci. Krejci delays and taps it in, and Lucic goes in after it with Jalmerson, but then with Keith. Rushed along to Horton, led to the back to Chara. Chara across to Seidenberg. His shot is blocked in front by Keith. Fidgeted on now for Hossa, and Hossa is able to jam it back out.
Well, missed opportunity there for Dennis Seidenberg to really fire that puck hard, and Duncan Keith was able to get in the way of it and prevent it from getting to his goaltender.
Oduya banked it around behind. Outletted by Seabrook. Poland connects back up the wing. Fickle with it there. Fans on the shot. Slams it angrily back in. All the way around it goes to Poland. Drugged it behind now for Shaw. Shaw tried to filter it through to Fickle and got it back to Shaw again. Trying to turn McQuaid. Shaw dropped it on the board. Chased down was McQuaid that time. Meanwhile, it's forced on back and it's played on by Bickle. Forced right back out to center by some tremendous defensive play from Patrice Bergeron. And right back now to Jágr. Jágr motors in, and we get a stoppage of play. And an offside. 4:29 left in the third. You're watching the Stanley Cup Final presented by GEICO. 1-1. A tense game. You see it reflected on the faces of the participants. Trying to break the tension that they experienced themselves, the fans. No scoreboard urging. They're just concerned and excited. And so they stand. Patrick Kane. Hanzus turns, leads over to Keith. On through to Hanzus, challenged by Paye. Came back to Keith. Got it on now for the carry back by Sharp. Tries to cross in, no sale. Boychuk with it there. Sharp working on him. Reinforcements arrive and Kane jabs away. 4 minutes to go in the third. Sealed up by Boychuk was Kane. It's sent on around and waiting for it. Roosevelt got out of the way of the hit of Paye. Ferentz dealing with it there. He and Hanzus, and then the puck came to Roosevelt. Slipped it right back around, and Hanzus behind. Shoved off by Ferentz. Kane takes over there. Kane steps to the outside and dropped it back on for Sharp. Slugged it behind for Hanzus. Watched there by Boychuk, and a drive by Sharp is held. by Rask.
Boy, Rask almost left the near post as Patrick Sharp shooting from where he almost scored, or where he did score back in period one. A little bit deeper, a little bit wider. Good possession down low. And watch Rask, he'll lean to his right, right there, and the puck goes back the other way. Good quick release off the pass from Michael Hanzus to Patrick Sharp.
That's a hard grinding shift for both teams, but when you're the offensive team, it's a lot easier. That put a lot of stress on Boychuk on the play.
Seidenberg ripped one around, that came right back near him. Chara took care of Hossa. Seidenberg fed one, that's stray one right out in front. And then it's sent back down the ice. No icing here because of the artful play of Horton. Now Seidenberg on back. Lucic couldn't start in because still in the zone was Krejci. Off of Taves. Cannot be reached by Seidenberg. He and Chara right now playing the different sides, the normal. Chara fed it up the boards, yanked on through to center, punted on across, and again read by Chara. Then Seidenberg, then ahead, and it's squibbed to Seabrook. Chara will chase this one down with Shaw. Chara went down, he and Shaw tangle, but icing is called. And Chara's annoyed, and that is part of the job description of Shaw.
He's been good at getting after Chara all series long.
Seen that a lot where trying to dump the puck in the corner of Zdeno Chara may not pay dividends right away, but it might as the series goes on.
Controlled by Marchand and headed to the back to McQuaid. Across now for a shot that is blocked out. Oh, the rebound was spiked on the wheeling backhander of Jágr. And out of play off of Chicago's stick. Offensive zone faceoff Boston.
Duncan Keith in front of the net. Beautiful pass from McQuaid to Ferentz. And another great defensive play by Duncan Keith. He'll find himself back to the front of the net. Redirect. There's Jágr with a chance. And then the stick again. He's made four or five of those type of plays in all areas of the ice. Real active here tonight in game two for number two, Duncan Keith.
Only played 48 minutes in game one.
One by the Bruins, drive by Boychuk. Oh, and that one caused Crawford to keel over, but he had it.
Boy, I'm not sure if Corey Crawford was set when this play developed. The quick little play developing. Ferentz in there. Corey Crawford kind of was looking around Nicholas Hjalmarsson. Watch, he's going to take a quick look. He stands straight up, and all of a sudden, the puck was right on him. It was one of those where he was trying to look around, and he went straight up.
And he made the save. Another Bruin faceoff win, but this time they have to play at center. Drop back in again. Delayed offside is wiped. They can forecheck. Marchand moves on Hjalmarsson. Meanwhile, this one went all the way back down, and it will kick free for an icing. And so it will be another offensive zone faceoff, a very important one for both teams, but the Bruins have been pretty successful in the last stretch of them here.
Claude Julien comes out with his big line of Krejci, Lucic, and Hort.
Krejci nudged it on. Horton got there, but lost to Boland, then got it back again. Floated to Lucic. Protects and drops it around behind. Keith turns with it there. Up the boards, taken on by Shaw. Shaw shoved from behind, and it's taken right away from him by Lucic. Back up to Krejci now. Got it to Lucic. Tried to get to the net, poked away from him by Shaw, who skidded along. Thrown by Chara, and blocked away up into the mesh by Crawford.
Boy, what an effort by Milan Lucic on Andrew Shaw in the middle of the ice. That back check, that back checking pressure. Moves this puck over. Quick little play by Krejci. And then Lucic, after being pressured by pressuring Andrew Shaw, Shaw does the same thing to Lucic. Coming back and denying that quick little two-on-one play. Never too late to come back on a back check.
One of the most amazing shots in the league is Zdeno Chara. Game one, he only had one shot on goal. He's yet to deliver one of his marketed howitzers. He's in a one-time position right now, but Pavel wins a draw.
It is Roosevelt steering it back off. It comes over near Seidenberg. dealt back through him and can be retrieved at center. Pritchard to fire back around the tall glass. Crawford tipped and Roosevelt took it. And blasted back in by Ferrin. Forechecker is Sagan. Directed back in by Kruger. Retrieved by Ferrin. Shoved down by Proleague. And Ferentz is slow to get back to his feet, but does. Pivoting with this is Proleague in the shot. Or beg your pardon, that was Johnny Oduya in the shot, went wide. Meanwhile, it is rolled along by Yager. Taken back by Bergeron. Walked on by Yager. Tries to finesse his way by Roosevelt. No sale. Rushing back up with it is Kane. Ferentz trying to defend. Coming across is Boychuk. Cross body block from Marchand. Tags around in front. And that one popped wide to the corner. Head along and it's taped up with it. Trying to force it away at the side of the net. They poke away at it and Yager is able to step away. Jaromir Jagr brings it on. Rolls one on to Marchand who pivots. 32 seconds to go regulation. Let it back to Chara. Moving on in. Chara circles around behind. Has a pass on to Marchand. Marchand with a shot blocked down. Stepping in the way of that one was Duncan Keith. Right back comes Saad. Pass is blocked away from Taves. Started back to Krejci with 15, separating the two from overtime. Keith nudges it behind. Jalmerson flipped it back along. Pinching along was Chara. It was floated off him. Steered back in with 6.1 to go and a neutralized faceoff.
Great opportunities for the Boston Bruins and Zdeno Chara in particular. Marchand hears him coming off the bench. Chara passes up a shot. He tries to get creative, Eddie, and he runs out of racetrack.
Passed it up because Kane did a great job defensively. And here, Patrick Kane. Joel Quenneville loaded up with Kane and Taves. Talk about great defense. There's the pressure again. Patrice Bergeron. Effort without the puck. Back checking by both these teams here in the third period, especially, has been outstanding.
And so, overtime again. The second straight final, we have overtimes in games 1 and 2. Before that, the last time it happened was only 1951. Coming up on the Subway Overtime Intermission Report, Liam, Mike, and Keith with overtime deja vu. Plus, it all comes down to goaltending. And as you know, without goaltending, Mr. O,
you got no shot.
None whatsoever. 28 shots, Blackhawks. 20 shots, Bruins. 48 in the game. 2 in, 1 apiece. Welcome back for Overtime, presented by Holiday Inn Express. Stay smart. 7th overtime this year for those guys. The Bruins sets a franchise record for one season. They have won 4 of the prior 6 this spring. The Blackhawks have won 4 out of 5. And so we begin. Saad spun it back in. Rolled to Chara. Challenged by Hossa. Played by Lucic. Blocked right back to him by Saad. Jalmerson with it there. Oduya cranks it back in. Chara flipped it further. Hossa got it there. Dropped it around behind. Poked on to Hossa. Hossa has had some magic in these occasions. Gets it back from Jalmerson and flipped one that's cut off right in front by Seidenberg. Steered off of Krejci and ladled back down to Weissing. Oduya races on and gives on to Jalmerson. Brushed right back and can be sent around behind by Ferentz. Played by McQuaid back to him.
Good play there by McQuaid. Buy some time. Did full wholesale changes with your defensive zone the farthest away from your bench.
And a lot of communication from Ferentz to make sure McQuaid knew he was available.
McQuaid led that one ahead and it's directed back on, but taken by Kane. On for Roosevelt. Offside is called. It must be the first thing across that blue line ahead of Blackhawks players, and that time it was not.
Well, I agree with Keith Jones, what he had talked about in that overtime intermission about Taylor Sagan, one of the more noticeable and more energized Boston Bruins. I think him and Jágr have really kind of found their game as this game has gone on. And I think Michael Frolik for the Blackhawks has been one of the better players for their side.
Here comes Marchand rolling back in. Got it onto Jágr. No, it rang off the pipe and out of play. And Jágr says it was just that close to being over.
Cross and drop with Marchand, Eddie.
Quick little turnover in the middle of the ice. There's that quick release. All in the wrist, all in the shooting position, and you see the Jágr looking up at the jumbotron for the replay look. The quick shot over the glove side of Corey Crawford. Nothing but iron.
Seabrook ahead, directed on back. Boychuk got it there. So is that an omen of things to come? Or will that be cruel fate at the end of the night? Boychuk touches up for Isaac.
Well, the message inside each locker room from coaches and players alike. Anytime that puck is in the offensive zone, people got to get to the net, and the puck's going to be directed towards the other goaltender. Don't pass up any opportunities to fire the puck to the front of the net.
One to Lucic, given on a cross. Boychuk drops one in front. Looks like a shot pass he was trying. Meanwhile, this is steered on by Seabrook and laid back out by Bowler.
Well, if he hadn't do that, Brian Bickle had done a really good job getting in the lane.
Marching to this one now, putting on the brakes was Horton. But it's played along by Seabrook. Horton able to spin it behind. Krejci able to play it there. Angles it on back to Chara. Has Seidenberg. Chara with a shot. That one ricocheted off a teammate, played back on by that teammate, Horton, and then it careened on back where Chara must retreat and play. Away from Saad, gave it across to Seidenberg, blasted around past Chara, up the boards, and directed by Lucic in a tangle there. Hjalmarsson led it back ahead. Gaining it is Saad, drive by Hossa! And it is Rask, after he blocked it, covered.
Well, Marian Hossa coming off a 10-shot performance in game one, gets an opportunity here in overtime. The second player in these playoffs to record 10 shots in a game in the playoffs. It happened four times, but only two players have done it. Hossa did it once in Malkin. Evgeny Malkin, the Penguins, did it three different times.
It is 4-6, the puck 1-3. Why is it so hard? Skipped along now and dragged around behind by Hanzus. Given on to Kane, through a bad angle try. That was what he was hoping for, but it's Ferentz throwing it along. Through by Doggevins, taken on by Kelly. Pulls and hands it up the wing now to Rich Peverly. Peverly looks ahead, he's got a man breaking Kelly. That one flown wide for Doggevins. Bumped there by Sharp, he brushed it along. Oduya steered it over. Hanzus connects with Patrick Kane. 3.25 gone, first overtime period. McQuaid tended that one on his backhand around for Ferentz. Skated down by Krueger, dropped back on again. Hanzus hit, puck to the back, poked right back along by Keith, settled down by Bergeron, steered out for Doggevins, Bergeron again, and up the wing for Jágr, trying to get there ahead of Keith, and Keith able to take over. Back up the boards, Marchand able to turn away from Boley. Hopped on to Bergeron, sent on back now, and a shot went through the crease wide. A hard drive from Boychuk, and another shot! Ricocheted up high, as at the front of the net was Bergeron for Boston. Jágr has his stick held, and play will continue. Right back on, it's brought on by Frolik. Frolik protects there, drags it around behind, chopped that by Krug. Turns one that is steered right out again by Rask. And filtered ahead now for Marchand. Marchand galloping ahead, trying to gain the zone. Ragging it at center, waiting for Marchand to get back on side with Krejci. Pushed right back in again by Krug. And it eludes the reach of Crawford, but no problem. The Bruins are changing. So Hjalmarsson bounced one onto center. Chara able to flick it along there. Carried back by Taves, trying to get it through Seidenberg. No luck. Where the defensive specialists for both teams are also the offensive guys. This one comes to Chara, handed across again for Seidenberg. Seidenberg banked it on in traffic off Hossa. Through traffic, reached and then guided back across by Krejci. Where do they get their energy from? That was Horton playing it back in. Settled down by Horton again. Reached for by Krejci. Helps it back to Chara. Across to Seidenberg and blasted back in. Third consecutive overtime game for the Blackhawks. The first was two. The next was three. This one at least one. Boychuk along. Directed back out to center by Sagan. Given right back to him again and he flies on. Sagan to the outside with it now. Wheeling around behind, gave it on back to Krug. Krug swept it across. Boychuk with a shot. That one blocked. Sagan reached it. Nudged on back to Krug again. Krug back to Sagan. Fires, and that one blocked along. Skittered on now to Paille. Paille around behind, away from Boland. Tied up by Boland. Loose puck taken around behind. Center down in front. Oh, and a great save made off of Kelly by Crawford. To the back, Boychuk. Given across to Krug. Head fake, turning, trying to shake away from Bickel. Krug able to tend it on. Backhand one in front. That is grabbed after it struck Paille.
Boy, what domination by the Bruins the last 45, 50 seconds. Support Tyler Seguin with some live legs. Using the points, moving the puck. Torrey Krug avoids the play right there by Brian Bickel. It throws his puck. If this puck is down low, it gives Paille an opportunity to make a play, but he had to try to catch it and place it down. That allowed Corey Crawford to be able to freeze that puck and get a whistle.
That's a line Claude Julien put together earlier.
Thrown to the front by Ferentz, tipped across by Bergeron, and it can be regathered and started back out again. Thrown by Seabrook and a save made by Raskin. A big rebound there. Ferentz took the hit, got it on to Jágr. Moving up with Marchand. Jágr has it, trying to fight it through to him. Marchand turns to the outside. Got it for Bergeron and a save. Crawford rebound. Thrown along by Keith. And it must be chased down by McQuaid. Off the stick of Marchand. Brought right back and the Blackhawks have to wait to get onside. Now Seabrook through the legs. Sharp drive. Oh, and getting a piece of that one was Rask. My goodness. Bounce off and can be played on by Marchand. Moving back in again. Got it on back. Horton shot safe. Rebound jammed off the top of the net. Around behind, they battle for it further. Sharp trying to play it along. Krejci got to it there. Laid it on back to Seidenberg. Skips across to Chara. Chara led it on over. Shot blocked away by Crawford. Around it comes again for Chara. Lots of Bruins pressure here, but it's broken by clearing it back down. Seidenberg in a race with Kane. Seidenberg turning with it there. Away from the reach of Kane, he's able to escape. Played it off the boards and got it out to center to Horton. Tucked it on across. Lucic moving back in. Has Krejci nearby. Delays. Passed one off the corner board. Horton there. Chipped one that went around behind off the glass. Played on by Lucic. Tries for Krejci. Gets Horton instead. Horton wheeling to the outside. He's got a point man there. Gives it on back for the hold by Krug. Lots of head fakes and a shot. Blocked around in front. Krejci reaching. Lucic up backhander. That would not go. Thrown back along again. Boychuk cannot take it. Hustling back for it is Krug. Arriving first is Bickel. Bickel trying to get around behind. Canceled out, but he got it back. And a shot by Shaw was saved by Rask. Shaw up with it again, turning. Andrew Shaw spun one, and that one popped up high and went out of play.
Chances at both ends. Torrey Krug comes over to make the hit on Brian Bickel. Bickel steps around him, gets it to Andrew Shaw. Game one, overtime hero. Great stop by Tuukka Rask.
And how about the Bruins at the other end? Milan Lucic, a glorious chance down low on the backhand. Corey Crawford comes out, makes himself look large. Here's another one. Crawford fights off, and they just can't get to the rebound to his right.
Boy, that was Nathan Horton with that chance. And, Doc, you picked it up beautifully. That puck, not very often the puck will ride across the top of the net. So that one certainly did. What an opportunity. Three or four A-plus chances for the Bruins here in overtime.
No icing. Paille got in the way. Anticipated well on Roosevelt. It's kept along and spun back to Paille. Turning but can't get a pass away before Letty intercedes. And it's popped up out of play. Will there be a penalty here?
Yes, there will be. Nick Letty. He put it up in the screen. The Bruins players reacted right away, Doc and Eddie. Joel Quenneville says it made contact. Let's see.
Well, the battle below the goal line. Dan O'Halloran right away made the call. There's Nick Letty. Did that go off the shaft of the stick of Paillet? Looked like the stick came across, but could not tell if the puck did touch the stick. Letty is standing in front of his player's bench, and you like what the officials did. They huddled up. They got four different opinions and decided that it was deflected, and that's why the faceoff is outside the zone. No penalty to Nick Letty.
They made the right call, but at the end of the day, this rule has to be reviewed. And I really believe it has to go to where the American League is. If you put the puck up and over the glass and it's not deemed to be on purpose, it's a faceoff and you can't change players in your own zone.
Pushed out of play right near Pierre in between the benches, and so that puck goes to a fan. 8:06 gone in the first sudden death overtime period.
Eddie, could you imagine a game, especially a Stanley Cup final game, being decided because of a penalty like that? Just, they've got to really evaluate that rule. I really mean it.
Yeah, well, considering it is a rule and the players have to live by it, players are too good to be able to kill the clock or get a quick whistle by shooting it out of the rink.
Sharp taken out by McQuaid, reversing now as Ferentz dropped back up the board. Tipped along by Sagan, gotten on to Kelly. Kelly doubles back, but Sharp is there dueling. Came right back to him, and he led it on to Hanzus, had to settle it down first. Letty gave it to Sharp and around behind. Ferentz inside the trapezoid to turn with it. Harassed there by Kane. Ferentz able to dub it along the boards, and it's forced on out to center where Paillet stopped it. Let it back up the wing. Toe drag there, trying to escape. Sagan is chased out of the corner by Letty. Poked along the boards again, and it came on to Roosevelt. And then Kane, and Chara will chase. Perhaps when we get a stoppage of play, we'll ask for a reassessment on fatigue. Seidenberg plays it on. Jager got it there. Knifed on back, and so it'll be chased down by Chara. And it is icing, and so, Mr. Ocheck, you are on.
Well, I think both teams have had some momentum, some surges here in overtime. I think the Bruins have had the better of the play, better of the chances, the high quality of chances, especially early in overtime number one. But as the period has gone on, the Blackhawks have seemed to find their legs. 8-3 in chances in overtime here in favor of the Bruins.
Shut down by Bergeron. Second effort gets it out to Shaw. Spins one further, and Bickle going to work on Boychuk. Defends him. Bickle backhanded one that went off of Rask. Marchand turning around behind for the Boston Bruins. Throws a long toss that goes skidding back. This is the period of the long change, as has been mentioned. The Bruins execute that with a splendid clear back down the ice that does not result in icing, or they would not be able to change. Set up there by Krug, played along to Boychuk, bangs it up the board. Lucic turning with it there, swings it on out, but it is collared by Jalmerson. Spun on back, but that blocked by Lucic, and he gets it back again. Can't pick his way through the quicksand of center, and so it's thrown in by Krug, who comes obediently to the bench for Boston. Jalmerson spun it behind. Oduya got it there. Back up the boards to Saad, halfway through the first overtime period. It's settled down and played back on the wing and set up for Lucic. Drops it onto the back. Seidenberg over to Chara. Chara's shot. It's deflected up off the glass. Lucic taking it there, dragging it away from Saad. To the outside, a couple of players on him, so it's dumped around behind for Horton. Stood up a bit there by Jalmerson, then swung at by Oduya. Horton delays and trickled it on through. Lucic helped it to the back. Seidenberg with a shot. Oh, and a block there as it went off and changed direction, but the block by Crawford. Around behind can be taken further. Dropped on by Horton, grabbed off by Taves, sent off the glass to center, Chara. Now it's the Blackhawks who want to get a change made here, but can't do it just yet. They are getting their forwards off because of this circle-to-circle play that comes to Jalmerson. Ripped back along, off of Rolik, sent further by Krueger, taken by Seidenberg, given to Chara. And then Seidenberg, drubbed ahead, all the way past Sagan and down, and icing. 9:01 to go.
Well, the Bruins catch a break here with the mandatory ice maintenance here after the 10-minute mark. The first stoppage, but opportunities in overtime. Jaromír Jágr with a chance. Patrick Sharp with a headhunter, as Doc likes to say. Nathan Horton with a great chance. Krejci with the second chance. And then Bickle to Shaw. Great chance, great play. Equal to the Tazan man right there, Tuukka Rask.
What are you hearing down there, Pierre?
A lot of communication, more so than what I heard in game number one in terms of making sure the right line changes are being made. Guys aren't overstaying their shifts. You're hearing a lot of positive encouragement from both benches. Boston didn't have Thornton playing a lot in the last game. They didn't have Thornton at all playing in the last game in overtime because of injury. And on the Chicago side, really professional, really focused, but they're all helping one another out in the line changes, Doc and Eddie.
Both coaches have talked about this period of time. It is a gift to be able to do some coaching while the ice is tended to, and also to get players a much needed rest. As they tend to this, the fans stand. Waving red, wearing red, trying to will home another overtime deciding goal. One by Hanzus, bounced back to Letty. Seidenberg got a piece of that one, but not all. Sharp with it there, dealt it behind. Played along by Peverly. Turned by Dockovans, given to Peverly. Moving back up ice. Peverly nudges it across, taken on by Sagan. Delays, slammed one, the pinballed across right to the shooting lane. It couldn't be settled down by Kelly. Onto the back, Ferris with a shot, kicked aside. Another hurried shot by Kelly. Scramble in front, Sagan tries to poke it home and can't. A kneeling block made there at the side of the net. Puck bounced on and can be played back at center. All the Bruins were bringing it that time, but could not force it home. Kane got in the way of that, then comes to the bench for a change. Marens' pass is cut, started back by Hossa. Moving on now for Saad. His shot is covered by Rask.
Boy, what an opportunity for the Bruins. Puck is bouncing everywhere. Fresh people coming on the ice. Chris Kelly, go D to D. Andrew Ferris with the shot. There's the opportunity, and what a stop by Corey Crawford. I think he stopped that with the paddle of his stick. And then Sagan looking for a second chance opportunity. What? Nice stop.
It was a marvelous one. And hopefully all of these won't be lost in the celebration by one team at the end. Kelly plays it ahead, angled it on, hoping for Bergeron. Coming by a Shaw. Away from Bergeron and to Crawford. Strong play at both ends by these two goaltenders yet again. Here's Marchand taking it in front, rising shot. Winds up going out of play on a deflection.
Eddie, there's your man again, Duncan Keith, with an active stick. They talked about having four or five on Duncan Keith earlier in the game. Marchand walks off the wall. Great tenacity from Bergeron. And watch number two in red come right over and get a stick in the lane.
Looked like Marchand wanted to give that puck here to Jaromir Jagr, who was to his right. Just that slight hesitation. But what a play again. And what an opportunity, though, along the board. Great forecheck there by Bergeron to create the chance.
Tucked onto the back, and it's Chara slugging it off the boards. Lucic turning with it there. Lucic got it onto the back. Seidenberg fires! Blocked down by Crawford. And it has floated back out again. What a leaping play made at the front of the net by Krejci. Carefully blocked aside by Rask. He was the one leaping in the way of Crawford, trying to cause him enough of a distraction that it would go into the net. Krejci played it off a glass support, turned along by Hjalmarsson. Blocked loose by Lucic, taken by Hjalmarsson again, and banged right back off the boards in a matter of self-defense and guilt. To the back it comes now for one that was held at the line, though disputed by Blackhawk fans. This is handled by Hjalmarsson and spun right back on. A hit on Bickle, played back off and can be settled down eventually at center ice by Horton. Played back on now for Bergeron, away from the reach of Marchand, and it's Bickle. 6:40 to go, first sudden death overtime period, game two, best of seven. Blackhawks won in triple overtime in game number one. Walked right back on again by Boland. Can't get the shot away. Good defensive job done by the Bruins there. And it's nudged on to Jágr. Jágr holds, gets it across to Marchand, and they rule offside.
Opportunities flow to high. Dennis Seidenberg with the shot. Look at David Krejci jumping up. And what positioning by Corey Crawford. Yes, there's a rebound there, but he gets some help from Oduya and Hjalmarsson. But working the puck low to high, meaning from below the goal line, out towards the blue line where your defensemen are. And a quality chance there from Seidenberg, and another good stop by Crawford.
Parents the blast, blocked right back out in front by Crawford for the take by Seabrook. Scaled along to Bowling off his stick. Turned right back over again and led on out for someone. Paye! He scores! Paye! And the Bruins have won it in overtime.
Brandon Bowling would like this one back. I think, Eddie, I know it's a tough play, but the puck comes around the wall and it leads to the opportunity for the Bruins in the offensive zone.
Well, Pierre's talking about Brandon Bolig. Puck's got to get out. The keep in, the quick little play, and then over the glove hand of Corey Crawford. The change of lines by Claude Julien, putting Paye, Kelly, and Sagan together, ends up being the difference in this hockey game after having a real difficult first period. They found their legs in the second, played real well in the third, and really dictated the pace in overtime. And Paye with the game-winning goal, and the reaction from the Bruin bench. What a pass from Sagan right to Paye.
They pour off the bench to celebrate an even series. Nathan Horton, Pierre McGuire.
You had a pretty good view of that goal. Tell us all about it.
I didn't see who passed it. I saw Paisley shoot in, went off the post. You know, we were all excited. We all jumped up. You know, it's a good feeling.
You didn't finish game number one. You were a huge storyline coming into game number two. How deep did you have to dig?
Well, you know, it's the Stanley Cup. Everybody wants to, if you can be in there, you're going to be in there. And, you know, there's no way I'm coming out. And, you know, I'm just happy to be a part of it. We got a great team, a great bunch of guys. And, you know, it's been a lot of fun. And, you know, it makes it even better we score.
Nathan, are you surprised at how tight this series has been so far?
Yeah, we knew coming in they're a great team. We watched them. They're fast. They got a lot of speed. You know, it's there's not a lot of room out there for both teams, and we're just trying to, you know, when we get the opportunity, we got to score.
Thanks for your time. We'll see you for Game 3 on Monday night in Boston.
Thank you very much, Pierre.
Doc?
It has been written if they played 100 times, both would win 50. They've played twice. Both have one victory. You're watching the 2013 Stanley Cup Final presented by GEICO. For Eddie and Pierre, Doc Sang, for Dollard Saint Laurent, Bob Morgan, Bob Birdy, Harvey Wittenberg, Joel Perlmutter, Glenn Scove. Interviews, reaction for both teams. Liam, Mike, and Keith on the Bud Light postgame after this.